Friends, in today's class we are going to see some of the examples on single dimensional arrays. Okay, so in this example it is given that write a program to read 5 elements in an array and display them. So our motive is to read 5 elements, so we have to ask the user to enter 5 elements which will be stored in the array. Okay, and also we have to display those elements. So initially we shall declare an array of size 5 because we are going to read only 5 elements. So we require array of 5, the size is 5, and also the data type is integer because they have not mentioned any particular data type of the element, that's why we are taking it as int. So initially we are declaring a variable which is an array of integer which contains 5 elements. Okay, yeah, then we would require variable I and value. Yeah, I is the variable for traversing the array. Okay, so I'll explain this in detail. So first we need to display that enter 5 elements, so we have to tell the user to enter 5 elements. So the user will have to enter the 5 elements continuously, right? Yes or no? He has to enter the 5 inputs continuously. Therefore we have to use a for loop, because in continuous manner he has to enter the input. That's why instead of writing scanf 5 times, what we can do? We can use for loop. That is the purpose of loops, right? So we don't have to repeat the things, just use the loops. You can either use for loop or while loop or do while loop, whichever you feel comfortable. Okay, in this example I am using for loop. Initially I will be initialized to 0 because we are going to read the inputs from index 0 to 4. Total 5 elements we have to read, so always the index starts from 0, that's why I is initialized to 0. I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Okay, so enter mod d element. So initially I is 0. What is this mod d? It is nothing but the first value of I, that is 0. So enter 0 element. So we are asking the user that enter the first element, that is index 0, index 0 element, that is our first element. So the once the user sees this message, he will enter the number, correct? So that will be done by using scanf statement. For reading the inputs we are going to use scanf, right? Yeah, since the data type is integer, we are going to use percent d, and that number will be stored in a variable called val. Val variable stores the input taken from the keyboard by the user. Understood? And since we are going to store it in array, the value will be stored in that particular index, that is A of 0. So the first input which is entered from the keyboard will be stored in the first element, that is A of 0. So the value which is entered by the user will be stored in the first element, that is 0th index, A of 0. That's why we are initializing A of I with val. Here I is nothing but 0, correct? Yeah. In the next iteration I will be incremented. Now I becomes 1, correct? And now we have to display enter 1 element, that is index 1th element. That is our second element. Don't get confused with the index and the number of elements. Okay. Yeah. Now the I value is 1. That's for 1 will be stored in this percent D. Okay. Yeah. Now scanf again is used to take the input from the user. The second value, whatever the user has entered, will be again stored in val, and again the val will be stored in that particular array, that is a of 1, because I value is 1 now. So a of 1 will be initialized with the second input. So in this manner we are going to store all the elements or all the inputs in the array. So finally, after inputting, so this particular logic is for reading the array elements one by one. So please remember this code, because in the future examples also we are going to use this logic. So in order to read any elements into the array, we are going to use this logic. Same logic will be used in all the examples. If you are reading any elements into the array, then we are going to use this logic. So this particular logic will read the array elements one by one, storing one value at a time. See here, storing one value in the particular array index. Okay. Yeah, after reading all the inputs, that is from 0 to 4, after reading all the inputs, we are going to display the array elements. Again, while displaying the array elements, we cannot display it directly. Printf mod d a of I. No. We cannot do it. Why? Because array is a combination of elements. So again, while displaying also, we have to display them one by one, one element at a time. So for displaying one element at a time, again we are going to use for loop. For loop is used to traverse the array elements. So if this is the array, okay, 5, no, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. This the first memory location is A of 0, and the second one is A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, and A of 4. Correct? A of 0, A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4. So in order to traverse this array, we have to use for loop. So for loop, in that we are going to use I variable. So I variable will be first initialized to 0. It means initially I will be pointing to the first memory location, that is 0th index, A of 0, first element it will be pointing. And then once I is incremented, when it is pointing to the first element, that is A of 0, that particular element will be displayed by using printf statement. Printf mod d element is mod d. It means 0th element is A of I. That is, A of I will give you the value of the element. Understanding? I will give you I. The variable I will give you the index value, whereas A of I, any array of index, will give you the particular element value. Whatever is inside this box will be displayed. So this particular, that is this first one, the I value is for displaying the index. This A of I will fetch you the ith element. Understanding? One, two, three, four, five. Yeah, I will give you this is a of 0. So I will give you this array index, whether it is 0th index, 1th index, whatever. But a of I, that is a of 0, will give you this value inside the array, particular array element. So a of 0 will give you the first element, a of 1 will give you the second element value. Please understand the difference. Okay. Yeah. So for loop is used to traverse through the array, that is move through the array elements, and then a of I is used to fetch the array elements. This particular loop will display the array elements one by one. This particular loop is used to read the array elements one by one, whereas this particular loop is used to display the array elements one by one. So you have to remember both of these logics, because in the future examples we are going to use these examples. That's why you have to remember these two logics. Okay. Most importantly, you have to understand the difference between I and A of I. I is array index, index value, whether it is 0th index, 1th index, second index, whatever it may be. Whereas A of I is the element, value of the element, that is value of that index. Is that clear? So the first mod D will display you the index number, and the second mod D will display you the value of the index, that is value of that element. Yeah, let's see the output of this. Yeah, first output is enter 5 elements. Enter 5 elements is displayed. Then what will be displayed next? Enter mod D element, that is enter 0 element, then the user will enter this element, correct? Enter 0 element and 20, this is entered by the user. This is the input taken from the keyboard, okay? Enter 0 element, and then the control will pause for the user to enter the input. Once he has typed any number, say any integer number, the counter or the control will go to the next step, that is it will be stored in the array, and then I will be incremented. So it will again display enter 1 element, enter 1 element. Again it will pause for the user to enter the number. So once the user enters 30, again I will be incremented, and it will go to the next step, that is enter 2 element, and 35 is displayed, or 35 is taken from the keyboard, and then it will go to the next step after incrementing I value. See, these are the I values, those are nothing but index values, but these are A of I's, values of those elements. What is the value of A of 0? It is 20. A of 1, 30. A of 2, 35. A of 3, 12. A of 4, 40. You have to understand this difference. Yeah. Finally, it will display the fifth element, that is index 4. Enter fourth element. Sorry, enter fifth element, that is index 4. So once the user has entered 40, what happens? I will be incremented again. So now I becomes 5. Once the user has entered the last element, I will be incremented again, and I becomes 5, and again the condition will be checked. I less than 5, that is 5 less than 5, no. Condition becomes false, that's why the control will come out of the loop, and then immediately the next statement will be displayed, that is printf array elements are. Again, in order to display those elements, we have to use for loop. For I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Same for loop we are going to use, because now the array has been created. We are going to traverse through that array and we are going to fetch the values. Yeah. So after this is being done, I'll tell you how the array looks like. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. In the first memory location, 20 is stored, 30. 35, 12 and 40. 20 is on A of 0 and 30 is A of 1, 35, A of 2, 12, A of 3, 40, A of 4. Okay. Now, in order to display these elements, we have to traverse or move through this array one by one. So, move through this array, we have to use for loop. So, for I is equal to 0, because index starts from 0. So, I is equal to 0, display the first element. So, this element can be fetched by using A of index value. That is A of 0, then A of 1, A of 2, A of 3, A of 4. The same thing is done here. Printf mod d, element is mod d. So, 0th element is the particular value. That is, in order to fetch that value, we are using A of I. Yeah. The output looks like this. Array elements are 0 element is 20, 1 element is 30, 2 element is 35, 3 element is 12 and 4th element is 40. So, this is the diagrammatic representation of above program. That is how the array is being stored in the memory location. So, in A of 0, 20 is stored, A of 1, 30, 2, 35, 3, 12 and 4, 40. See, if we want to fetch the values of 20, 30, 35, 12 and 40, then we have to use A of the particular index number. That would give you. So, if you use in printf statement, if you use A of 0, then it would print you 20. If you use A of 4, then it would print you 40. Then it would print 40. Is that clear? Yeah. In the next video, we are going to see one more example. Okay.